It all started when my mom met my dad and they had me. Hi, I'm the universe and this is the story of my life.
At first there is nothing, and then for absolutely no reason there is something. That's the Big Bang at t equal to 0 seconds. The Big Bang occurs in which ordinary space and time develop out of maybe a gravitational singularity, something like a black hole. But then it starts expanding and something causes it. It may have been dark energy or dark matter, we don't know yet, but it does start expanding and it never stops. The infinite universe cools as it begins expanding outward. It is almost completely smooth with some quantum variations here and there. All the four fundamental forces, the gravitational, the electromagnetic, the strong and the weak interactions, were all one super force at this point. But then gravity separates and begins acting on the universe. The remaining fundamental forces stabilize into the electronuclear force, also known as a grand unified force. We are now entering what's known as the electroweak epoch. Temperature is falling down rapidly. As a result, the strong nuclear force becomes distinct from the electroweak force, perhaps fueling the inflation of the universe. Note that the time is 10 to the power of minus 36 seconds, that is, not even half a second has passed. And here is when we come to the crucial part. For no reason whatsoever, the universe starts inflating. The space suddenly and very rapidly expands like crazy and the temperature drops horrendously. So that the size of an object as small as a virus would have been expanded all the way to the size of a galaxy. Everything happened in far less than a second. There is good evidence that this happened. Let's come back to this moment. 2020, the year of COVID-19, 13.6 billions of years later. See, in whichever direction you look, you still can sort of look back at Big Bang billions of years ago. So you kind of measure the temperature of the universe moments after the Big Bang. Whichever direction you choose, this way, that way, the temperature seems to be pretty much the same. And this actually poses a very fundamental puzzle, because the light of Big Bang from that direction has just reached us billions of years later. But this light had never had a chance to go all the way back to the other end of the universe, which may take another billions of years. And so this part of the universe and that part of the universe have never communicated with each other. But then how come they know that they have to have the same temperature? Not just these part, everywhere universe seems to have the same temperature. But how could they arrange themselves that way if they haven't ever met? And that is a very big mystery. It's like having discovered two remote islands in very different parts of the world. But if you go there and talk to the local people, they speak exactly the same language. And even with the same accent, that's how similar they are. Then you don't have to be a genius to come up with a theory that, well, they must have talked to each other in the past. Which means that this part of the universe and that part of the universe had communication at some point. That way it can arrange itself to have exactly the same temperature as we see today. What inflation does is it stretches out this universe by an incredible amount. But when it was very small size, everyone was close to each other and they could really talk to each other. That way they could arrange themselves in a sort of what we call equilibrium, such that everything had the same temperature at that stage. Even though they got stretched out and they got separated for billions of years, they still remember that they arranged themselves to have the same temperature, the same energy, and so on and so forth. That's what inflation is supposed to do for us. It solves this major puzzle. There is one other subtle thing. The laws of physics at subatomic scales has this uncertainty principle built in. Vacuum is not empty, but it's active. It's like this. Energy is bubbling in and out all the time. So if you're here, you may borrow energy for some time, but you have to give it back. Or maybe you can lend some energy to others, you need to take it back again. But as long as everything works out in the end by conserving energy, it's okay. So you have this vacuum which is lending and borrowing energy all the time. And then you also have this inflation that is stretching out the universe so quickly. Put these things together and we find something really interesting. When the universe was very tiny in that small confines of space, there was this big uncertainty principle at action. And you keep borrowing and lending energy all the time. Suppose you borrowed energy from somebody else, but then the universe gets stretched so quickly, then the person you need to give energy back is now gone forever. Again, you are stuck with energy you borrowed. So combining uncertainty principle and this rapid expansion of space, you're in the end stuck with a small variation of slightly more energy here and slightly less energy here. That's how we believe that the structure of universe was formed today. We owe that back to this quantum noise from uncertainty principle during the inflation. But the exact reasons of why inflation happened are still being explored.
Thanks for watching, and what happened after this is what we will discuss in my next video. Maybe share and subscribe and stuff like that.